you very much for joining me today. There was two earthquakes that yesterday there on Mount Diablo in the Bay Area, a 2.9 and a 1.6. USGS did not fudge about this earthquake. Yeah, it came in as a 2.97. And I'll show you the seismic signature. Caught my eye. There was two of them. Here's the other one. Only because many years ago, decades ago, I had a dream about Mount Diablo, which I believe came from God. As you know, I used to live in the Bay Area. And interestingly, Mount Diablo does have some volcanic vents over here on the eastern side of the mountain. In an article I found on the Mercury News, here it says that for more than 40 years, conservation groups have been telling people that the 3,849-foot tall Mount Diablo, a landmark reference point for airplane pilots and geological surveys, is not a volcano. And it says nothing has changed that. Mount Diablo does have volcanic rock high on its slope, but the rock stemmed from eruptions some 165 million to 190 million years ago. Then the rock rafted by tectonic plate movement. 400 million to 26 million years ago, before the mountain was formed, though, magma pushed up to the surface east of what now is Clayton, a result of a series of hilly domes shaped like mushroom caps in a 1 mile but 4 mile area along sparsely populated Marsh Creek and Morgan Territory roads between Clayton and Brentwood. These dome-like structures are a few hundred feet tall at most. The dome's outline are difficult to distinguish from ordinary hills because they're mostly covered with brush and dense canopy of oak and laurel trees. All right, so going back to Google Earth, here's Mount Diablo. Here we got Clayton, and over here we got Brentwood. And somewhere over here would be the small vents that they say are volcanic in nature. Earth activity along such faults as the Morgan Territory in Greenville likely opened up cracks in the Earth's crust, allowing the lava to bubble up. When these faults first formed, they acted like a leaky conduit, allowing magma to ooze up from the deep underground, said Ken Lavin, a naturalist who leads hikes and talks on Mount Diablo's natural history. The magma erupted from small vents and fissures, not big volcanoes. So he found a pinkish colored rock right there, pinkish crystal rock on the lower section of the dome. The pink rock high in silica seemed out of place. Volcanic rock here? Adams recalled thinking. Well, it turned out that pinkish rock was rhyolite, high silica volcanic rock. Yeah, with lots of gas and lots of bubbles. And evidently, the only area where you can visit to see this volcanic rock is Perkins Canyon. So here we have Mount Diablo, and let's go to Perkins Canyon, right there. Let's zoom in a little bit. Those that live there, you guys might want to take a little field trip and look for this rhyolite. Yeah, it's pinkish in color. So going back to the dream that I believe that God gave me of Mount Diablo. In the dream, I was down there at the beach in Pacifica. In Mount Diablo, you can see from many areas there in the Bay Area. But anyways, in the dream, there was this blinding white flash that came from the direction of Mount Diablo. And then shortly after the flash, the ocean started boiling. I was on the beach there in Pacifica. A warning came over the radio and loudspeakers that a tsunami was coming. and for everyone to start heading for higher ground. Telling the details of what I was shown, I believe I was shown what happened here. One friend said that it was probably an atomic blast, because that's the only thing that would make the ocean boil. It was like little ripples in a pan of water boiling. You know, I believe it was one of the dreams that I was shown of the end times. And then the tsunami came and martial law, and San Francisco was destroyed. A FEMA camp was erected across the bay somewhere in Oakland by some railroad ties. Or not a ties, but, you know, a junction, a railroad yard, I should say, was a FEMA camp. And that was the beginning, I believe, of world events that led into World War III. Yeah, so when I saw these earthquakes here, you know, I've always wondered about this bright white flash that I seen from Pacifica. Let's go to Pacifica. Like I said, I was standing on the beach. And let's turn this around. There's Pacifica, and I could see the top of Mount Diablo, which is up over here if I was standing there on the beach. You know, probably looking up through this little area, the Valley Sharp Park, and I could see the top. And like I said, it just, boom, this bright white, huge light, and all the water started boiling. But anyways, yeah. You might find that interesting. I don't know. It perked my interest when I saw the earthquakes here. So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.